Dad, you have won 5 Melbourne Cups. Tell us a little bit about each of those experiences.
Well, Emma, they're all a bit different in a way because the first one was a little bit unexpected with some outsiders running 1-2 in the race. It was good for business. And then, of course, Sub-Zero in 92, when you took the trainer's trophy to school for show and tell, that was quite special because a very good friend of mine, David Cobritz, owned that horse with some other people, and he's still a great friend and an owner in the stable, so that was quite good. Then Doremus came along and really looked a good thing after winning the Caulfield Cup and only going up to about 55 in the Melbourne Cup. So, and then of course the Maccabi era with just looking at the old girl down there on the lawn there, she's looking very good. It was extraordinary because you know, no mare had ever won 2 Melbourne Cups, which she did, and then to come to the third and the focus that was on that for the day was, you know, probably a moment in Australian sport that people will always remember.
It's the race that stops a nation, and for some reason, it's the race that every trainer, jockey and owner wants to win. Why do you think that is?
Well, it's an iconic race. It dates back over 150 years. And in the modern era, it's been really well managed. They've got it out to the public more, even with the tour of the trophy around Australia, and that it brings all those communities into play, and it's an icon thing. It's like you know, in the old days winning a Davis Cup or
a Wimbledon,
you know. Yeah, it's an iconic thing, and it's something that everyone looks forward to every year because it is so iconic.
How are you feeling going into Tuesday?
Yeah, I'm really excited. I haven't had a runner in a Melbourne Cup, I don't think, since Maccabi won in 2005.
Really?
Yeah, I don't think I have.
That surprises me.
And if I have, it was something fairly nondescript, so and therefore not thought worthy. So, no, I'm excited. I'm excited about being part of it as a professional again, instead of just being on the sidelines. And the build-up's been great. You know, there's been a lot of hard work done by everybody to get our horses to where they are. And you know, it's probably the biggest week in racing anywhere in the world now, and probably one of the biggest sporting events in the world as well.
Thanks, Dad. Good luck.
Thanks, Emma. Lovely to see you.
It was great fun talking to my dad about his love of the Cup, but he was, of course, not the only person dreaming of success.
Gay, you won the Cup 2 years ago. How does that feel?
Well, as your father would know, Emma, it feels fantastic. It's the most prestigious race. It's the race that the world stops for to look at. And the number of nations that are aware of the Melbourne Cup, there's no other race in Australia, and probably not in the world, that's so well covered. The internationals that come here, you know, makes it a really hard race to win. But I think I've got a real live chance, 2 really live chances there on Tuesday.
It's a great honour to have a runner in such a great traditional race like the Melbourne Cup.
It's for me one of the top 5 to 10 races in the world. It's very hard to win. It's a race that stops your nation, but it also stops the world now.